take a look at this toolbox from We Are. It's absolutely aspirational for anybody in the electrical industry to own. In this video today, we're going to pull out the 9 essential tools that you will need in the electrical industry, regardless of whether you're an apprentice or you're retraining to be an electrician. When you stay on at the end, I will also reveal a magic 10th tool.
Tool number one, the PZ2, the Pozi 2 screwdriver. The screwdriver here matches the head of the screws that we'll use in a college setting in order to mount our electrical accessories to wooden surfaces and in industry to brick and block walls. This screwdriver is an absolute must.
Next, we have the faithful Spirit level, used for checking the vertical plane with the bubble staying between the two lines, and also for checking the horizontal plane, again with the bubble between the two lines. Perfect for leveling off a single accessory, or if we want to add a second accessory, we can level it against the first, making sure that they're perfectly level. And remember that old saying, level on the floor?
Is a level no more. Next tool up is the side cutters, predominantly used to cut cables to length. It feels like I'm in the Bank of England here with the price of copper at the moment. First of all, I'll go for this low smoke, zero halogen cable here from Doncaster. But Marcus is going to need some 1.5 millimeter squared twin and CPC cable. So I need to cut a bit of that for him.
Cheers, Gaz. Asked for 1.5 and he sent me 1 mil. So my favourite of the bunch, moving on to the electrician's claw hammer, okay? So as you can see with this We Are claw hammer, we have a nice, solid, smooth face, okay? That's handy for driving in nails, cable clips. We have a lovely flat claw here, okay? With it being flat, helps us to get into hard to reach places. Again, designed for removing nails and clips. And we also have the convenient butt, okay? Now, this is designed maybe to use when we're inserting wall plugs into a wall, rather than having to use the heavy front face of the hammer. So I'm just gonna cut this 1 mil for you guys.
As we reach the halfway point in this essential tools list, you've all been waiting for it to appear, and yes, it does now. The electrician's knife. I use it for removing the outer mechanical protection on PVC, PVC twin and CPC cables, as well as flex. However, if you think it shouldn't be in this essential list, make sure you leave in the comments the tool you'd like to replace it.
I've managed to find the festoon light in that Gaz missed earlier in the video to show you these combination pliers. Now, like the side cutters earlier, these can be used to cut cable to length, but also take the insulation off of the conductors themselves. Now, the benefit of these is once you've took that insulation off of the conductors, we can then go and double over our conductor end.
Next up is the 5.5 mil flat-headed screwdriver, used to remove the screws in the front of socket outlets and switches, but also used to tighten at the terminations within those sockets. You have to make sure that that blade actually matches the screw in which you're tightening onto.
So that 5.5 mil flat-headed screwdriver we've just seen is perfect for socket outlets. However, for light switches, we need to look at something like a 3.5 mil flat-headed screwdriver. This is perfect for doing up the terminations inside of this light switch. I also am a fan of using this for the box screws on the front of these accessories. What I'd like you to do is put a comment below on which screwdriver you prefer to use for these.
In order to tighten the connections within the consumer unit, I'm going to use my slotted Pozi 2 screwdriver, not the Pozi screwdriver we saw earlier. This screwdriver is used to tighten up those terminations, but not the required manufacturer's Torx setting. In order to do that, you'll need a We Are Torx screwdriver, and I'll leave a link in the description to a training package we've made on that.
So as promised, we're on to the 10th magical tool. However, it's that magical, it's disappeared along with Rick. You can find it right over here.